it lies closest to me as a singer.
You have a new album out, An Acoustic Night at the Theater. Can you explain how the track listing has been decided?
Well, the set list, the way it's now on the CD, is not the way we played it, but this is for a nice build-up for the CD, I think. We tried several things, and this was just worked best to our opinion. But live, what we did was like 45 minutes acoustic, and then 15-minute break, a union rule, and then another 45 minutes with full four songs and some acoustic songs. And that build-up was really the way the songs we chose for the set list was a combination of our own favorites and I think our fans' favorites. Also some weird songs, more less obvious songs were on there, like for instance Towards the End, which is a B-side track of a single. I think not all the fans know this song, so that was also maybe a surprise for a lot of people.
You were saying your own favorites and fan favorites. Let's start with your own favorites. What songs are on this album that you say that these are our own favorites?
Caged and The Cross, yeah.
And why specifically these two songs?
I don't know. It's lies closest to me as a singer, the way I sing, but also the lyrics. It's something personal for me. So it's
I don't know if you want to go into it, but these two songs, can you say what is the personal aspect of those songs?
The lyrics, but also I think it's sometimes you have like a certain magic around the song that it comes so naturally that it feels so natural when you sing it again. There's nothing nothing artificial about it, nothing thought of like, okay, to make a song better in a way. It was, when we wrote it, was immediately the way it was recorded. You know, we never changed anything in between. We didn't try different vocal lines, didn't try different choruses or something. It was the way it was perfect the way it was. And that's the magic what I feel about these songs as well. And that makes it more special for me than songs you really had to work hard for, and sometimes even in the end feel a little bit artificial in a way because they didn't come directly to you. And when they come directly, it's a little bit of magic.
And how many songs did come directly to you?
I think like, well, maybe it's like 25%.
That's
still pretty much, but it would be nice if it would have been more, of course.
does it get more or does it get less? I mean, when you write songs, you've written many songs, maybe sometimes it can become harder, or maybe it can become easier.
It's different with every album. So it's not like it's getting harder because I've written so many songs already, so no.
Is there one album that you can say, well, it's more magical album because of the songs were coming directly from you? Can you say maybe one?
Well, I think probably the two most magical albums for me in writing in that way was probably Mother Earth and the last one, The Heart of Everything.
Okay. Any specific reasons? If you look back in hindsight?
It just happens sometimes. It's no particular reason for it. That's really strange in a way, because if I could trigger it, I would, because I think these are the best songs when you write them that way, because they come so naturally.
Okay, so those two songs were your favorites?
Yeah.
Fans' favorites?
I think probably Towards the End, which is a B-side track. And I think Pill is also a fan song. There's so many.
Okay. Yep. But why these two songs, do you think?
Why these two songs? I think because we didn't overplay them, maybe also. And also because they're in a way special, because there were B-side tracks, fans always tend to go to songs that we don't play that much, because then they become more special, because they come to so many shows. They we have fans that come, like when we do like 20 shows, they come like almost 15 shows, or maybe sometimes even 20 shows, and then it becomes more or less more special for them, the songs we don't play that much, of course, which is also logical in a way.